I know you want your free games already, so I'm gonna make this fast. For the requirements, you need an Android phone or tablet. Unfortunately, this doesn't currently work with iPhones. Next, a USB cable that's USB-C on at least one end. If you have one of the newer phones that use a USB-C charging cable, you can use the cable that came with your Quest or your phone. Create and verify your developer account using the link in the description. Log into the Oculus Developer website using the same Facebook account that is linked to your Quest. You can verify your developer account by adding a credit card or your phone number to your Facebook account. Create an organization. Enter any unique name and agree to the terms. Enable developer mode on the Oculus app. You can find the SideQuest Android app on the Google Play Store. Launch SideQuest and tap on Get Started. The red dot on the SideQuest logo at the bottom indicates that your Quest is not connected, so connect the two devices. Allow everything and choose SideQuest each time it shows as an option. Put on your headset and allow USB debugging and access to device. If you get stuck here and there's no enable USB debugging window in your Quest, turn off developer mode and turn it on again. As you can see, the red dot is now green, which means your Quest is connected. Sideloading via USB drains your phone's battery really fast, so it's best to do this over Wi-Fi. Be sure your phone and your Quest are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Tap on the Wi-Fi icon at the bottom left, then enable Wi-Fi. If successful, it will bring you back to the previous page. If this appears again, you need to enable USB debugging on your Quest. Disconnect the cable and the green dot will turn red again, but that's okay. Go back to the Wi-Fi options and it should say connected. If it doesn't, tap on connect. On to the fun part. There are thousands of titles to choose from. There are demos, paid apps, but most of them are free. Simply tap on the title and then the download app button. To check the download progress, click the arrow down button next to the SideQuest logo. If your headset goes to sleep, Wi-Fi will be disconnected and your downloads will fail. One of the ways to prevent it from happening is putting a sticker on the sensor. But if it does go to sleep, wake up your Quest and tap on the Wi-Fi icon again to reconnect. If you restart your phone or your headset, Wi-Fi will be disabled and you'll need your USB cable again to enable Wi-Fi. SideQuest just added a disable proximity sensor feature which prevents your Quest from going to sleep. As of the date of this upload, this feature is available only on the desktop version. If they add it to the mobile version in the future, you'll probably see it in tools. There are games here that don't need to be sideloaded and can be downloaded the same way as the official Oculus Store apps. You'll know it if the download button has the word Oculus. When you tap on download, it will open the download page in the Oculus app. If it opens the Oculus app but not take you to the download page, simply use search. In addition to free games and apps, there are other interesting things SideQuest can do for you. Click the three dots on the bottom right corner and go to Tools. It can change the screen refresh rate, set the video capture size, change the texture resolution, and more. Some of these can cause performance issues, but don't worry because a simple restart will fix that and restore the original settings. If you find this video helpful, leave it a like and consider subscribing for more Quest stuff.